Hi, my name is Julia, and welcome to the Travis Touch setup video. Today, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about how to set up your device, connect it to the internet, update it, etc. So let's get started. First of all, for the unboxing of the Travis Touch device, this is the box that it comes in. When you open it, the first thing you see is, of course, the device, which we will get to in a second. After that, there's also a few more things in here. There's a small leaflet in different languages. There's the user manual, which comes in English, Spanish, and Chinese. And there's a small eject tool that we'll use later. So now, let's move on to the star of the show, Travis Touch. Travis Touch is equipped with a lot of great technologies. It all starts with a 2.4-inch touchscreen. At the top of the device, you can find the speaker, and across the device, you can find multiple microphones. These are here to make sure Travis understands you clearly, even in noisy environments. At the bottom, you'll find a micro USB connector, as well as a 3.5mm headphone jack. The power button is located on the right side of the device, and if you're using a SIM card, please insert it into the left side. Speaking about the SIM card, let's put it in. Now, let's see how to insert the SIM card. On the left side of your device, you'll see the SIM card slot, and with the small pin ejection tool that you can find in the box, put it in the small hole underneath the slot and press gently, and the tray will pop out. Then take your nano SIM card and put it on the tray like so, and then put the tray back in the device with the metal part facing upwards. Once you put it back in and the device detects it, it's gonna ask you for the PIN code. And if you don't know your PIN code, please contact your provider. When you turn on your Travis Touch, the first thing you see is the main interface. Here, you can select two languages by tapping on the different flags. Above that, you can find the settings menu on the right and the translation history on the left. Above that, you can see several icons for Wi-Fi, mobile reception, Bluetooth, and battery percentage. To increase the volume, swipe up from the bottom of the screen, and to lower the volume, swipe down from the top of the screen. The first time you switch on your Travis Touch, please connect it to Wi-Fi. To connect your device to a Wi-Fi network, tap the settings icon on the top right, and then click on network. Then click on Wi-Fi, and make sure it's switched on. You'll see all the different networks that you can connect to, and then choose your network, and if it has a password, enter the password, and you're good to go. Once it's connected, you'll see on the main screen that the Wi-Fi icon at the top is white. If it's not white, it means that the connection failed. Every once in a while, we're gonna release software updates that include extra things such as maybe additional languages or some bug fixes. To know which software version your device currently has, go to the settings menu and scroll down to about. Then click on version and it'll show you the version that you currently have and if there's a new update available. If there is, you can read the instructions here, so you have to make sure that your device is connected to a Wi-Fi network and that it has over 50% battery because the update drains the battery a bit. After that, you restart your device and the next time and when you turn it on, you'll be able to install the new update. Now that your Travis Touch is properly set up, it's time to start enjoying the conversations it translates. In the next video, my colleague and I will guide you through the process of translating.